Merli, I hope you get this message. Your answering machine sounds weird. I can't even understand what's said, so I hope you get this. This is Katie. Just give me a call. I think I've got a solution.
And that sweetheart, Steve, snowblowed the whole driveway. Fine. Beautiful. Thank you. Bye. Saturday, 10:31 a.m.
Season. I don't know when we'll be back up in the area, but we'll certainly try to make a swing over to Stevens Point sometime so that we can catch up and visit. I hope you're feeling better. I did talk to Kathy and she said that you guys get out here.
Is to be made in about 5 copies. Other copies will be given out as we need to. Mr. R.F. Jones. The attached information is a resume of engineering and development that has to be done on all models that we have or are developing. Also included are improvement suggestions as well as complaints. I have collected from the field and sales personnel of Steelmade Incorporated as well as from people outside the company. Merlin put each division or each machine on a separate sheet of paper. Number one project, Coca-Cola redesign of the door. The design has been changed.
Thank you. Traveling vast distances with the speed of thought. I first of all found myself among a tribe of savages, where I was present at a ferocious battle. However, I was not in the slightest danger, since I was both invisible and invulnerable. From time to time I looked at myself, that is to say, towards the place where my body would have been if I had had one, and I was able to assure myself that I no longer had one. I thought of visiting the moon and immediately found myself there. I saw volcanic soil, extinct craters, and many other details, which were evidently the reproduction of things I had read or engravings I had seen. But they were all strangely enlarged and brought to life by my imagination. I was perfectly aware that I was dreaming, yet was far from convinced that there was nothing veridical in what I saw. The admirable distinctness of everything I looked at made me wonder whether perhaps my soul really had temporarily quitted its terrestrial prison. If this was really the case, it would after all be no more marvellous than many another mystery of creation. I thought of various opinions of the ancients on this subject, and remembered the following passage from Cicero. If someone had ascended to the heavens and had had a close view of the sun, the moon, and the stars, this would nevertheless give him no pleasure if he had no one to whom he could recount it. I immediately wished to return to Earth, and found myself back in my room. For a moment I had the strange impression of looking at my sleeping body before taking possession of it again. Soon after that, I dreamt that I got up and, pen in hand, was writing a minute account of all that I had seen. Finally, I really wake up. Almost immediately, innumerable small details of my experience, which a moment before had been perfectly distinct, vanished from my memory.
If it is correct to classify this experience as an out-of-the-body experience, it is nevertheless atypical in one respect. It is unusual for the subject to imply that his out-of-the-body experience, even if it occurred during sleep, was subsequently subject to the same sort of amnesia as a non-lucid dream. On the contrary, it is more usual for a subject to say that his out-of-the-body experience is more memorable, even everyday waking experience.
Thank you. Ich weiß, wer ich bin, aber ich weiß nicht, wer ich bin.